JBN, we keep you informed. I am Michelle Jones, and in the news, two St. James men charged with gun crimes. Two St. James men were arrested and charged with firearm-related crimes in two separate incidents in the parish. The police say 37-year-old Lucian O'Connor, otherwise called Broker, of Providence Heights, flanker in St. James, was charged with illegal possession of firearm and ammunition last Thursday. Lawmen said that at about 6:30 a.m., a joint police-military team armed with a warrant went to O'Connor's residence. During a search of the premises, a Taurus 9mm pistol with a magazine containing 10 9mm cartridges was found inside a bedroom wrapped in a sock. He was arrested and later charged following an interview. In the second incident, 27-year-old Shadeen Murray of Lilliput in the parish was on Monday charged with wounding with intent in relation to an incident that occurred in the area on Friday, February 5. The police said that at about 2:45 p.m., Murray allegedly attempted to abduct the complainant at gunpoint. A struggle ensued. The complainant was shot but managed to escape. The police were called and the injured man taken to hospital for treatment. Investigations led to the arrest of Murray. It was placed on an identification parade that same day, where it was pointed out by the complainant. The court dates for both accused are being finalized. Clarendon man fatally shot by police. The police fatally shot a man in Clarendon on Monday. He has been identified as 24-year-old Kashif Douglas of Woodside in the parish. The police stopped a vehicle during a spot check at about 5 p.m. in Woodside. It is alleged Douglas exited the vehicle with an illegal gun and was shot. The police have arrested the driver and another passenger who were in the vehicle. Gunmen kill St. Elizabeth man. The community of Denby Castle in St. Elizabeth was the scene of a murder on Wednesday night. A man was killed and his vehicle set ablaze. He has been identified as Jerome Hilton, a spiritual healer. According to police reports, Hilton was at home at about 8:30 p.m. when armed men entered. They shot Hilton multiple times. Two other men who were at the house escaped. The St. Elizabeth police are yet to determine a motive for the attack. St. Anne man charged for stealing $300 and a cell phone. 24-year-old laborer Dominic Brighton has been charged with burglary and larceny after he broke into a house in Greenwich Acres, St. Anne, and stole $300 and a cell phone on Wednesday, February 3. The police say 33-year-old Damien Newman has been charged with receiving stolen property after he reportedly purchased the SIM card and cellular phone from Brighton. The police said that about 11:30 p.m., Brighton forced open the window to the bedroom of a dwelling house and stole the cash on a Samsung Galaxy S8 cellular phone. A report was made and an investigation launched, leading to the arrest of Brighton and Newman. Their court dates will be announced at a later date. Construction worker falls to his death. A construction worker fell to his death at a work site in Droxall, St. Anne on Monday. He has been identified only by his alias, Bujo. Reports are that the man was working at a construction site at the Boot Service Station complex in Droxall about 1:30 p.m. when he fell from the third floor of the building. He was rushed to the St. Anne's Bay Regional Hospital, where he died while undergoing treatment. The scenes at the service station and hospital were processed by a person from the Police Era 2 Scene of Crime team. The body was later removed by St. Michael Funeral Home for storage. In another incident, a taxi operator planning the exchange to authorized route in St. Anne was robbed of his 2014 Toyota Probox motor car on Monday night by two men. The cabbie, 45-year-old O'Neill McClarty of Bonham Spring in St. Anne, was not harmed during the incident. Reports are that McClarty was operating his taxi cab around 8 p.m. on Monday when he picked up two men at the exchange taxi stand. The men claimed that they were going to Ocherails. Upon reaching the entrance to Content Gardens, the men indicated that they wanted to stop. When the driver stopped, one of the men brandished a knife before pushing him out of the car and drove away in the direction of Ocherails. Investigations continue into both incidents. Man fatally shot by police in Portland. The Independent Commission of Investigations, Indicom, has launched a probe into the shooting death of a man by the police in Portland on Wednesday. Information so far is that a man believed to be of unsound mind attacked a civilian in the Port Antonio area and the police were alerted. It is alleged that the cops, upon their arrival, were unable to subdue or restrain the man, who allegedly attacked one of the police personnel and was shot. The man was rushed to the Port Antonio Hospital, where he was pronounced dead. The matter was reported to Indicom. Two men brutally murdered in separate incidents in Westmoreland. Two men, including an elderly farmer, were brutally killed in separate incidents within 24 hours in Westmoreland. The deceased have been identified as 62-year-old Gladstone Morris of Barneyside and 27-year-old Elroy Brown of Mount Stuart District, both in Westmoreland. In the first incident, Morris, who is believed to have suffocated, was found with duct tape on his eyes, nose and mouth, his hands and feet bound, inside his house on Tuesday morning. The Bethel-Town Police report that about 8 a.m., an alarm was raised by residents after Morris's vehicle was found abandoned in Mayfield District in Hanover. After being summoned to the area, the police inspected the vehicle and found several household items believed to have been the property of Morris. Lawmen later proceeded to Morris's home, where his lifeless body was found. His body was removed to the morgue pending a post-mortem. Meanwhile, Brown is suspected to have been killed and his house set ablaze with his body still inside on Wednesday morning. According to reports, about 12:45 a.m., residents of Mount Stuart heard explosions coming from Brown's house and later saw the structure ablaze. The police and the fire department were summoned and cooling down operations were conducted. The charred remains of Brown were later found among the rubble. The Westmoreland police have launched separate probes into the incidents. Government to again assess keeping schools open for in-person classes amid COVID-19 surge. Minister of Health and Wellness, Dr. Christopher Tufton, says another assessment of face-to-face classes will be conducted during the current midterm break to determine whether schools should remain open. The government has been hesitant to order a closure of all schools despite the dramatic rise in COVID-19 cases in Jamaica. Dr. Tufton says the government is constantly assessing the situation in relation to schools. Protocols are strict and have worked to the extent that we have identified cases. There's still always going to be risk, but so far we have been managing. I think we'll have to review on a week-by-week basis. I think schools are going to be out for the next few days, the minister said. Dr. Tufton added he was sure the Minister of Education and Cabinet would review where we are and an appropriate decision would be communicated to the populace. The Jamaica Teachers Association has made several calls for the discontinuation of in-person classes, especially with more schools reporting positive cases among students and staff. Three more COVID-19 deaths, 294 new cases. Jamaica on Wednesday recorded three more COVID-19 deaths, pushing the tally to 384. The deceased are a 31-year-old woman from Kingston and St. Andrew, a 71-year-old female from Manchester, and a 58-year-old man from St. Elizabeth. One more case was recorded as a coincidental death, and one other fatality is being probed, pushing that figure to 12. Meanwhile, there were 294 new cases, with ages ranging from 63 days to 90 years, pushing the total to 20,310, with 6,939 being active. Of the new cases, 141 are males and 153 are females. In the meantime, there were 46 more recoveries, increasing the total to 12,781. The cases were reported in Kingston and St. Andrew, 117, St. Catherine, 92, St. James, 34, St. Anne, Clarendon, 13 each, Westmoreland, 8, Manchester, 7, Hanover, 6, St. Mary, 2, St. Thomas and Portland, 1 each. Some 253 persons are in hospital, with 22 being moderately ill and 21 critically ill. 4 persons are in government quarantine, while 20,754 are at home. JBN, we keep you informed. Please remember to subscribe, like, share, leave us a comment, and click the notification bell to receive our daily news items.